Hi friends, so far we learned what aggregate demand and aggregate supply meant and what factors influenced them. In this video, we'll see how the aggregate demand and aggregate supply function look like and how equilibrium is achieved between them. We'll also learn what effective demand is and how greater demand for products can lead to a higher employment and output. Welcome to the Sagar Raut Channel, friends. Let's study the Keynesian theory of employment. A short disclaimer that I want to share with you all is that I might go a little away from the syllabus and talk about certain things. I want you all to understand how policymakers made use of this theory during the Great Depression to finally achieve growth. I hope you all understand that practical application of a particular theory is more important to understand than just the theory. So, let's begin. We know that aggregate demand is nothing but the sales proceeds or revenue that the entrepreneurs expect. So, think about this. Say, I plot output and volume of employment on the x-axis and aggregate demand on the y-axis. An increase in employment, that is, number of jobs in the economy, the output will also increase. Hence, I can plot them together. Plus, if the overall employment is high, then the expectation about the amount of revenue that the entrepreneurs will receive will also be very high. To understand this, place yourself in the seat of the entrepreneur. As an entrepreneur, if you see all the people around you having jobs and earning well, then you'll expect them to spend more and hence expect more revenues from the business that you conduct. This is why, as employment increases, aggregate demand will increase too. Notice that this area shows us the autonomous consumption that a society does. If you remember, we studied in the aggregate demand video that autonomous consumption is a type of consumption that is done even when your income is zero. Here, zero income is shown by zero employment and output. Now in your textbooks, you might see the aggregate demand function shown somewhat like this. This showcases a positive relationship between employment and aggregate demand. However, in reality, the aggregate demand function looks like this. This shows that aggregate demand starts to rise at a diminishing rate as we get closer to full employment. This makes total sense because a country has only finite amount of people producing finite amount of output. Population might be huge, but still finite. Hence, when a country has a smaller population which has jobs, the entrepreneurs will expect more revenue with every unit increase in employment. However, as the employment starts reaching near full employment, the expectation of revenue will start to fall with every unit increase in the employment. This is because there will be fewer and fewer people left who can demand things. I know, this part might have got your head spinning, but go through this once more and you will get it. Now remember that aggregate supply is the minimum amount of revenue that the entrepreneurs expect. So, as employment and output increases, their expectation about the minimum amount of revenue should also increase. Hence, our aggregate supply function looks like this. This function, in the beginning, will grow gradually, but as the society reaches near full employment, the expectation of the minimum amount of revenue that the entrepreneur should get will start increasing at a faster rate. Notice that once full employment is reached, the aggregate supply function becomes a straight line. This is because everyone in the economy has jobs now, so the function cannot go beyond this area. Watch the video on aggregate supply if you have problems understanding this. Now let us see how equilibrium is formed between the aggregate demand function and aggregate supply function. Notice some point on the x-axis over here. At this level of employment and output in the economy, the total demand for goods and services is here. And the total supply for goods and services is over here. In other words, the amount of revenue that the entrepreneurs expect at maximum is over here, and the amount of revenue that they expect at minimum is over here.
you can see that the demand in the economy is very high, which will prompt the entrepreneurs to produce higher. To produce higher, the entrepreneurs will employ more people and there will be rise in employment. However, even here you can see that the demand in the economy is higher than the supply. Hence, the entrepreneur will produce even higher by employing even more people. This will continue till this point, where the total demand and the total supply for goods and services will be the same. This point of equilibrium is what Keynes referred to as effective demand. According to Keynes, this is the point that determines how many people have jobs in the economy. Now, this level of employment is not the full level of employment. These many people are still jobless. And the only way to reach full employment is to get the point of effective demand at this point. But how do we do it? If you remember, in the aggregate supply video, we learned that the supply of raw materials, land, building, etc. is fixed in the short run. Hence, it's not possible to do anything to the aggregate supply function. The only way to reach full employment would be to move the aggregate demand function. This point of effective demand shows full employment. Can you guess what this means? This means, according to Keynes, the way to achieve a higher growth in the economy is by increasing demand. Keynesian theory gave more emphasis on demand than supply, which is in direct contradiction with the classicists. I have made an interesting video on this subject. Do watch it. You will learn about two different schools of thoughts and how they contradicted each other. Plus, you will learn how economics has evolved since the last three centuries. If you find this video useful, do let me know about it in the comment section. Do share it with your friends if you feel they can benefit from this. Thanks for watching, guys. Adios. Hasta la vista.